Have you ever heard of the idea that the insurance business of building an agency and recruiting agents to sell for you is the best form of creating a passive income? Well, I'm going to counter that argument from firsthand experience of someone who has built an agency, and while that's not exactly the case, and then give you some information on how to actually create a passive income without the necessity of having to recruit a single insurance agent and simply rely on your personal production. My name is David Duford, owner of Duford Insurance Group. I train and recruit agents nationally to sell final expense, Medicare, and annuities in my virtual agency, both face-to-face and over the phone. If you'd like to learn more about joining Duford Insurance Group, click the links above or below. Thanks for watching. So what we're gonna talk about today is how you can actually make passive income without having to recruit insurance agents to sell for you. But before we get into some of the ways you can do that and kind of the avenues you can go, I want to talk about how recruiting is not really truly a form of passive income earning. So the biggest problem with recruiting is that you can't just walk away from your agency and expect it to perform without your presence, at least especially in the beginning, maybe at the higher echelons, but certainly not in the beginning. Now, why is that the case? Because think about it, if you leave your agency and your job is to find agents, recruit them in, and then train them, and then support them, you really, at any point where you walk away and don't and aren't made available to help with any of that, you don't really have a passive source of income. You have an active source of income. And what happens over time is that some of this can be outsourced, some of this can be managed, to a point where I think you could argue building an agency, especially in the life side, can be a semi-passive source of income. But it's not as truly passive as some of the insurance products that are built that pay a residual income are. And so all of this is to say, if you're being told that the way to wealth and riches is exclusively through building a team, and you're not 100% hot on recruiting agents into an adult babysitting scenario, you don't want to be that guy that does that, and you're looking for other strategies, then you're right. It's not as easy as it makes it out to be, and you have to be actively and intimately involved with your agents to help them grow in order to succeed. That's how I approach the business. And the last thing I would ever say is that this is an actual passive type of business, because as soon as you treat it that way, and you're not there to train, show up, help, etc., agents leave you, they go somewhere else, you create a bad reputation for yourself, and it's harder to recruit agents when bad news is out there. So it's something you actually are going to be involved in on a very active basis. Never discount that. So if you're not hot on the recruiting because of that, and you're really interested in a truly or very close to passive stream of income from the insurance business, where can you go and what products can you sell? So what I'm going to talk about here are some of the most common ones, and I'm going to tell you why of all of those, I actively pursue in training my agents how to do and try to sell you on why you should at least consider to do it, whether it's with me or with somebody else. So first one on the list here is property and casualty insurance. So this is your car insurance, homeowners insurance, etc. These products pay a residual lifetime annual commission that is pretty significant. And if you accumulate enough products, you're gonna make a nice flow of income that all you have to do is just take care of your clients when they run into problems and answer their questions when ready. The only problem I have with the P&C business is that it is not passive, really, when you think about it. As soon as a client gets into a car wreck or their house catches on fire, you are really going to be super involved in getting involved in filing the claim, getting involved in the service side of the business, and it takes you away and distracts you from the enjoyment of the passive income, not to mention the active accumulation of client side. So I don't see P&C as being the best source of a passive income in the insurance business, albeit it's not bad. I just think there's some better options of what we'll get into. Next on the list here is the under 65 health insurance market, and that's basically Obamacare or the Affordable Health Care Act type of products. And the reason I don't like this business is my sense is there's a lot of people that switch out of plans with the rate increases, and people aren't as necessarily long-term committed as they used to before the ACA programs came out in the early 2010s. Although it is a form of passive income, I just have never been hot or sold on it and don't know a lot of agents in the business who have crushed it like some of the other products here as far as making a real-life passive income. Third on the list here is disability insurance, and this is one of the few rare products that have a significant first-year commission, but in a significant passive income. The problem is tapping into a market that you can get in front of enough people to make it worthwhile. This is one of those kind of white collar products that you need to have a referral base or know people in the business, because a lot of the people you'll sell disability insurance to are gonna be doctors, lawyers, attorneys, et cetera. And so the typical type of marketing system, like a mass marketing system like Final Expense or Medicare, is a little bit harder to come by. But if you write several hundred of these a year, you can see all sorts of opportunities, not just on a great first year income, but certainly on a residual base as well. And the last one on the list here, which I'm going to talk about at length here, why you should certainly consider it, is selling Medicare type policies. So here's why I like Medicare. First of all, it goes hand in glove with which many of you are already doing, which is final expense or life insurance products. If you're selling to seniors, especially if they're disabled or retired, they likely are already on Medicare and most likely have Medicare plans that you can help them with. So anybody you sell life insurance to becomes great prospects automatically for Medicare, which means that you can offset your lead cost by starting to sell the clients you accumulated over the years that you sold life insurance to who are in their senior years. And then second of all, the residual pays for life, especially if you sell a Medicare Advantage plan. As of 2021, they're going to pay, I think it's $290, maybe a little less than that, $288, each year for the life of the policy as long as the client's alive. So you could have people that stay on for 5 years, 10 years, and more that continually will pay you $290 thereabout dollars every single year for that policy. And what actually is really nice with Medicare plans is you don't have a lot of service work that is very common with a lot of these other products like PNC. When a client has a question about their plan, you can certainly help them to a marginal extent, but it's likely they're going to call up the company to file a claim, get assistance with, et cetera. So your work required relative to something like PNC to actively service your clients is nominal relative to PNC and other products. So for me, I'm convinced that Medicare sales, specifically Medicare Advantage sales, is the absolute best place to be to generate a passive stream of income. Because not only is it something that all of my agents are actively already seeing out there, and there's an inherent built-in client list that people can work, the demographics and some of the trends demographically are on our side too, with people turning 65 at the highest rate ever, continuing for decades. More and more people are going to be in the older age range. Everything is just lined up to make this opportunity wonderful to get into the Medicare space and to generate a passive stream of income from it. So this is why, if you're not 100% sold on agency building, you should absolutely consider building an agency around finding Medicare prospects to sell Medicare Advantage clients coverage. And from that is an enormously awesome opportunity to not only develop a significant stream of income, but to develop a significantly passive stream of income, to free yourself from the grind that work is to an extent, and be able to do other things besides constantly working all the time. And it is truly something that is absolutely available in the Medicare space of selling Medicare insurance. And if you'd like to learn more about how this would work, of course, I'm telling you about it. It's because I do it. And I love it. I'm sold on it personally, and I'm trying to sell you on it too. If you'd like to learn more, I would recommend that you go to the links above or below. It's going to take you to my website. I've got a lot of resources there on how Medicare works, where you can kind of go down the black hole of how our system works and how Medicare works at a large level or a bird's eye level. And if it's something you're interested in, you'll see the steps you can take to inquire to learn more. And if you have any comments or questions how Medicare works, or certainly how recruiting versus Medicare works, leave them below. Happy to help you there. And I hope you otherwise enjoyed my video and my content. And thanks as always for watching, and we'll see y'all next time. Take care.